born mateys! Have you ever wondered what it would be like to be a pirate? Well, join us every week as we sail the seven seas, learning how we can be a purple pirate. A purple pirate is a pirate whose captain is Jesus. We're gonna learn how to be more like him with what we say, what we do, where we go. So you don't wanna miss out.
Nellie, what are you doing?
I'm taking selfies to post on PirateGram.
What? You don't even look like a pirate. You don't have your pirate clothes on you. Where's your pirate hat? You don't have your parakeet or even the patch on your eye. If you're gonna be a pirate, you need to look like a pirate all the time.
Well, I didn't even think about that.
You better go get your pirate clothes on before that someone finds you on this ship and thinks that you don't belong and tosses you overboard.
I think you're right.
Yeah. All right, Purple Pirates. While Nellie goes and she gets ready, we're gonna learn today what it means to be recognized as a Purple Pirate.
Hello, Purple Pirates. Are you ready to learn our memory verse? Okay, this week it's Philippians 4:8. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatever things are honest, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Okay, that was good, but now we're gonna say it in some different voices. Let's say it in a pirate voice. Arr, are you ready? Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, or whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatever things are pure, or whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things. Arr. Okay.
Kids, I have this really cool object lesson I want to show you. Hey, First Mate Jack. Do you think you can help me with this object lesson for the kids?
Oh yeah, sure.
Awesome. Well, it's not gonna take very long. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Kids, I have First Mate Jack here.
Hello.
And I have these two glasses. One of them has salt and one of them has sugar. Can you tell from looking which one is the salt and which one is the sugar?
Nope, I cannot.
Nope. Well, let me help you out. How about you take this cup and I'll take this one and pour it in and let's mix it. Give it a little stir. All right, now, can you give them a little taste and now see if you can tell which one is salt and which one is sugar?
Sure. This one is sweet. That one's good.
That must be the sugar.
Ugh.
So clearly that's the salt. You don't like it?
No way.
Oh, but wait, what if I added some fruit punch to the salt water? Do you think it would taste a little bit better?
No, not at all.
Oh, what? Good idea. They said, what about if like we added a little bit of lemon or some fruit to it? Would that make it taste better?
No way.
Really, kids? It seems like First Mate Jack is letting us know that it doesn't matter what we add to this salt water, it's still gonna taste like salt water. God created salt and he created sugar. He created the sugar to be sugar and the salt to be salt. Just like us. Mm-hmm. He created boys and girls. He created the boys to be boys, mm-hmm. and he created the girls to be girls. He decided who was gonna get the special gifts of being a girl or a boy. And that's it. We can't do without either boys or girls. We need both the way God created us to be. Perfectly in his design.
second chance to sing a brand new song. You opened up my eyes to see. You rescued me. Rescued me. You showed the way when there was no way out. Cleared up my mind when you erased all doubt.
Purple pirates. People knew who pirates were by the clothes that they wore. Now, this wasn't any fashion show. Almost everything that they wore served a purpose. It was meant for something. Now, hats, they were used to say, It was the who's who on the ship, that everybody would know who the captain was, who the first mate was, by looking at their hats. Now, scarves, they were used, they would tie them around their heads. Because, it gets really windy out there on the open ocean, so they would tie it back so that their hair wouldn't fly in their face, or they'd put it around their waist to hide their knives, because they didn't have pockets, so they would put their knives in their sash. Now, the coolest one, guess what an eye patch was used for? An eye patch was used. Have you ever been outside when it's really, really, really sunny, and then you walk inside somewhere where it's really dark? All of a sudden, it takes a while for your eyes to adjust so you can see again, right? Well, pirates didn't have that kind of time, so they would keep an eye patch on one eye, and it was used to the dark. But when they need to go into the belly of the ship, they didn't want to trip down the stairs, so they moved the eye patch to the other eye, and the eye that was used to the dark could see under where there wasn't sunshine. How cool is that? Wow. Well, they honored their role as pirates by the clothes that they wore. And purple pirates, we're the same. God created us to be boys or girls. He created you with the eye color that He wanted you to have, blue or green or brown. He created you just the way that He wanted. Now, pirates, they were known by what they wore, and people would know, hey, that's a pirate. And they would know who they belonged to, who their captain was. Purple pirates, we're the same. When we say, God, I just love who you've made me to be, who you've created me to be, that's worship to God. That's honoring God. That's being a purple pirate. Now the devil, he tries to lie and tell us that we're not important or you're not special, or tries to make us ashamed for who God made us to be. Says that we're a mistake. Well, that's not what my Bible says. Let's look in the book of Psalms, chapter number 139 and verse number 14. It says, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully, that means greatly. So for I am greatly and wonderfully made. Wow, I'll praise God because he made me wonderfully. He made me greatly. He made me just the way he wanted me to be. Marvelous are your works, and that my soul knows right well. So God created us just the way he wanted us, greatly, wonderfully. Point to yourself. Say, me? Yeah, he made you special. He doesn't make mistakes. So you don't have to change anything because God made you who he wanted you to be. And it was wonderfully and greatly done by God. So, Purple Pirates, we need to thank God for making us so wonderfully. Will you do that with me? Jesus, we're so thankful that you created us just how you wanted us to be. We praise you for it and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hey, Purple Pirates, so glad you joined us today on our voyage where we learned that God made you super special. Guys, he made you pirateers, and ladies, you princesses, as we all learn what it means to be a purple pirate, following our captain, Jesus. So we'll see you all next week as we sail the seven seas.
Joyous Julie. I'm back. How's this for a purple pirate?
Oh, you definitely look like a pirate now.
Perfect.
Take selfies with me.
Okay.